Hi everyone, I'm John, Johnny Laser, whatever. lately I've been testing, I was making a project for my grandson for Christmas. He likes soccer, so I made this LED panel for him with his favorite soccer player. Now, to do an LED panel, diode lasers cannot do an LED panel. You have to add something to it. So a lot of people paint them black, just like glass, because the laser goes through. I saw one video where a gentleman used a piece of black construction paper behind. And so when I did that, and when I lasered it, I noticed the etching was going into the construction paper. So I thought to myself, can we laser construction paper? So I took a design, and sure enough, lo and behold, I started making prints. And this is just plain construction paper, nothing fantastic about it, but it lasers absolutely fantastic, and it's so easy. This is a great beginner project. Any beginner can just take these and start lasering within a couple minutes. Let us go through them and I will show you how to do it. It's going to be that easy. First of all, let us prepare the paper. Okay, so follow me over here and we will do the paper. Now, this paper, I just go to the dollar store and I get it. We call it, in Canada, it's construction paper, Bristol board. Kids use it for projects and whatever. So, just simple paper. And what we do, I like to cut it up. Something like for a test, 6 inches, you know, roughly. Doesn't have to be accurate. Just take it using a simple box blade. Be very careful, it is sharp. And that's it, you just cut it. Simple as that. And then we'll make it a little smaller so we don't have to have a big cut. Let's make this some more here. There you go. Three small sheets we'll test it out on. Okay? One moment. Now, from a previous project, I cut out for a jig for my mirrors. I save all the big pieces. So this is a nice square piece. I take this, I take the piece of paper, just place it down flat. Using painter's tape, I tape it down. Because you want it flat, okay? Now, the laser's focal length is very forgiving, so don't be worried if it's a little bendy or whatever. It'll work just fine. And just like that, you have a piece of paper taped to a piece of wood, and it's ready to go. That easy. Here we're heading over to the trusty S1. Now I have the S1 with the 20 watt module. We take our piece of paper and we just place it into the laser. I just sit it down. I don't put the magnetic stands or anything. Bring this over, and I like to line it up a little bit with the tape there. See? Okay. As simple as that, then we're ready to go. Now, all we have to do is choose a picture. So let's go on the internet, and we'll grab a picture. Let's see here. We'll go to this website, which is ideogram.com, or whatever, and we'll just choose a nice picture here. I don't know. Let's see. Oh, picture of a young lady. Okay. Looks kind of sad. Okay, let's go find a happier one. Picture of a dragon. Everybody wants to do a dragon. So we'll just download this picture. We go to the download here and we download it. And it's downloaded. All right. I like to use ImageR. Now, ImageR you could use for free, but it's takes a long time. I pay the monthly basic, so I get it and I use it all the time. We'll just turn on ImageR. Like so. Bring up our picture. And now you could use grayscale or colored. I keep it in color because it really doesn't matter. Go to our downloads where we downloaded it. There's our dragon. And let's open it. As you can see, the dragon comes up. If you want to crop it, we're using a little 4-inch section of sheet, so 4 or 5 inch. So let's make this a little smaller. Get rid of the sky. And there we go. Now let's resize it. I go over to inches. Take the biggest one and say 4 inches. And I change the DPI. The best DPI I found for the xtool 20 watt is 318. You know, you can set it up to do tests. It gets a little in depth, but trust me, 318 is a good number. So we'll click in 318 and click it on. Now let's add a little, sharpen it up a bit, nice and sharp. Bring up the gamma. I like to go click about 4. Just to highlight it a little more. It's a little dark. Let's go 5. There we go. Not bad. Now I will save the original, like so, into actual paper. All my photos. Save. Now before we can use the photo, we have to treat it like a negative, okay? Because you're lasering onto black paper, so you want it as a negative. So you go to invert, and it'll. Invert it, looks like a photo negative, and click save. Now we have it saved. Ah, we're ready to laser. Simple as that. Turn on our xtool, creative space. Now you can do all this in xtool creative space, not a problem. We'll go through that later, okay? We'll do one more with the same one with the xtool creative space. All right, let's a new project. I like to save the project right off the bat, and being an old designer for 40 years, I get in the habit of saving every once in a while, which is a good thing, you know, power outages and stuff. And we'll save this as come on, under paper. We'll save it as dragon test dash test. Simple. All right, now we're going to click off the focus. Now you can define your material, you don't have to. I like to define, I just keep it on brown craft paper, makes no difference. So let us focus, we hit the focus. Don't mind me, I love my coffee. Okay, now that we have it focused, let us set up the area for marking where we're going to laser. I use the rectangle, click start marking, go up here, and we mark 2 corners. 1 and 2. And that's it. And the marking, and you're done. Now you see the area where it's going to be lasered. Let's bring in the photo we just did. Paper, we're going to download. And we're looking for the dragon. Come on, dragon, where are you? Oh, there it is. Here we have a lovely picture of a dragon. Now let's get the biggest use out of this. So let's turn it 90 degrees. There we go. And we'll put it in the corner. Open it up a bit. There we go. It's ready to laser. Now, with the paper on my settings, I have it set. I clicked it and I saved it on black paper, paper black. We're using power 15, speed of 350, grayscale, lines per centimeter, 160. At this point, I'm going to save. We're going to frame and go to processing. Now, I've turned on my inline fan and let us frame it. Click frame. It comes up where it's going to be, just so we can see. Okay, that looks good. All right. Hit process. This takes a while because usually at 318 dpi the file is quite large. The more detailed the file, the bigger the size, the longer it's going to take. Hit start, transfers the program over to the machine, and we'll wait. And waiting. And waiting still. Still waiting. And that's it. And you hit start. And off it goes. Okay, we are all done. We open her up, pull it out, and there you go. Take the tape off. And we have a simple design of a dragon. Ready to go, ready to show off. And this is by far the easiest beginner project anyone can ever do. All right. Well, it came out very nice. This is the dragon. As you can see, just simple paper. Easiest beginner project anyone can do. Total time, 20 minutes. I hope you like this video and hit like, why not? I'm not affiliated with xtool. I'm not making this program for them. All I'm doing is people have been asking me, how do you do that? And well, I have to keep explaining. Well, now I got a video. And if you like it, if you like some of my work, I'll make more videos. Hit like, ask for topics, and we'll see what we can do. Alrighty, till then, happy lasering. Johnny Laser, we'll talk to you later.